Welcome to Cebu, Expat by Matt Wilkie, discussing expat life in the Philippines.
Crab mentality and family business. This is something I've had first-hand experience of when we first got together. But basically what you have is that maybe a family business is already operating. The family business, maybe a small store, for example. And you've got a few ideas on how to expand it. For example, most don't have refrigeration, so if you've got a fridge already, you can sell soft drinks, etc. They might actually draw in new business or expand on the existing business. Or maybe you want to decorate it, expand it. Anything that involves money going into a family business. First issue we've got is that the business isn't yours and it's not seen as your involvement. Anything you're seen as inputting can be seen as being gifted. As such, the people running that, because like say it's your wife's parents, aunt, whatever it is, it doesn't matter who, but they're not your wife. So for them, if you're gifting that money, how they spend it is up to them. Now, I know already some people are going, what? That's not what I would agree to. But that's the point. You would actually say, right, there's 11,000 pesos, go and buy a fridge. And the next thing is they go and buy some rice, maybe go out for a pizza. Maybe the money gets siphoned off onto other things. Maybe it's paid for kids' tuition somewhere or something. Your money just gets frittered away or abused or just spent. And then they're going, you promised me a fridge. And it's like, yeah, but I already gave you the money. That is very common. The other side of it is the crab mentality, right? When you do a business and it's functioning, you can get the family actually having an issue with it being successful. For example, say the family had a store that's two blocks down, and then you open one in your yard that your wife runs. There is this competition that the one that's a few blocks down will not like the fact that your wife's doing better than them. Doesn't matter, they're all related. It's a chip on the shoulder thing. It's crab mentality. The Philippines has a lot of it. It's famous for it. But I wouldn't say it's just the Philippines, but I would say when you look at China, for example, there's certain traits that gets the Chinese to be successful anywhere on the planet. The Philippines, due to some of this crab mentality stuff, they actually pull themselves back because there's this whole competition thing going on. I don't understand it. I don't get it. But that's something to be aware of. Because they do some stupid things to throw Spanish in the work when they can. You get the barangay captain coming to harass you. You'll get the fire officer. You'll get the who else could come up? The local mayor's office for permits. All stuff because your business is doing better than theirs. And that, in fact, your wife's related to them. How bizarre. But these are the two things I would say to be very careful of with small businesses revolving around family connections. Not all Filipino families are like this, but some people can be very disruptive just for the sake of it. So you just need to be aware of it. And if you can see that there's issues and maybe your wife says something that doesn't seem right, it may be the fact that she doesn't want to tell you the aunt's wandered off with the cash. She might say, oh, the money was lost, it was stolen, blah, 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 because she does not want to get into that confrontation with you. I'll cover that in another video, actually, about family confrontation. Thanks for watching.